I am Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today, we're all about the export. So we're going to take a look at the settings I use to export to YouTube. Now, what I've got here is the video tutorial from the other day that shows you the teal and orange effect, which everyone seems to be enjoying. And I want to export this again. So I tap on Share Export, I go to Movie, and I do it one of two ways depending on my mood and what I'm doing on that day. If I want to export the video and upload it at a later date, I use Photos. If I want to export it and get it straight up to YouTube, let's do the YouTube option. So we tap on YouTube. Now we've got resolution. I have experimented with putting videos up in 4K, but to be quite frank with you, at the resolution you're watching it at, 1080p is more than enough. So why increase the megabytes and export a video in 4K when very few of you are probably watching it on a screen that takes advantage of 4K? I generally just leave it to 1080p upload. Frame rate for my video tutorials happens to be 24 frames per second, so that's kind of locked in. Frame rate for my video tutorials happen to be 24 frames a second, so that's kind of locked in. And then the quality is set to standard 20 megabits per second. That seems to be the sweet spot. The thing with YouTube, Vimeo, and all these sites where you upload videos to is that they're going to compress this as far down as they can, but still retain a reasonable amount of quality. The cool thing about YouTube is that it delivers it in different sizes automatically for you. Although sometimes when you're exporting at 4K, 6K, and I think they even support 8K video now, it's going to take a while for that to obviously render through. So they render through a lower quality pass, 480p or 360p, and then they go up to 1080p reasonably quickly these days. It's actually quite amazing how fast that happens. But if you set the quality to 20 megabits per second, that's a nice wee sweet spot for YouTube to handle. Audio quality, I tend to set it to 44.1 kilohertz. Yes, you can go up to 48 kilohertz, but it's been captured by the microphones in the iPad, and I think 44 is absolutely fine. Video codec, well, I tend to leave it in H.264. I have sometimes played with H.265, and I don't require transparency, so I don't bother with that either. So I tend to go to the default of H.264. File format, generally speaking, I set it to an MP4. Sometimes it comes across as an MOV, but that just comes down to the fact that if you want HEVC with transparency, it has to be an MOV file. 360 VR is not applicable, and then all I've got to do after that is basically upload it. Now, when uploading to YouTube, you have a couple of extra things to do, which is give it a title, a description, and I don't tend to tag it. Category defaults to film and animation, and I've kind of uploaded my videos to that category. It seems to suit things, and privacy wise, it goes up unlisted to start with. The reason for that is that I want the video to go through all its processes we can upload. So what I'm going to do here, highlight it and just put test, upload, description, not applicable at the moment. I'm not even going to add any tags. I tend to tag it once it's uploaded and see which tags are appropriate, what I've used in the past, that kind of thing, and do that directly through the YouTube Studio app, the same as applying playlists and things like that to it. Then we just tap upload. And the one thing I will say about LumaFusion over Final Cut Pro, DaVinci Resolve, or Adobe Premiere is its ability to render and encode the video file and get it up really, really quite quickly. And if you've got a reasonable internet connection between 8 and 20 megabits per second upload or faster, then it doesn't take long to put up a gigabyte of data at all. And I tend to just let this do its thing and then go and have a coffee or go and do a chore. But you've got to keep the window open for the purposes of the upload. And that's it for this video tutorial. If you've enjoyed it, it's been a simple one, then give the video a thumbs up. If I've earned your subscription today, by all means, subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to tick the bell to be notified of another video tutorial. And I'll catch you on the next one. See you later.